Okay. Last time we discussed given a vector space, what we mean by a basis for that vector space. So basis is a set of vectors from our vector space. They should be linearly independent, and their linear span should give us all of our vector space. And we wrote a theorem stating that if you start with a vector space and take a subset B of V, then the following are equivalent. The first condition was B is a basis of V. The second condition is B is maximal linearly independent set in V. And the third one is B is minimal spanning set. So the second condition tells us that B is maximal linearly independent, means that if B consists of n vectors, and if you take n plus one vectors from that vector space, that subset must be linearly dependent. And in terms of when I say minimal spanning set, if you take a smaller set, a proper subset of B, you shouldn't be able to span all of V. Okay, so let us prove that those three conditions are equivalent. So bunu yazdım değil mi? Üç, proof. Okay, now the proof. Okay, so let us start proving one. The first condition implies the second condition, saying that if B is a basis of V, then B is maximal linearly independent set in V. Okay. So first, since B is a basis, so it is linear span, it is spanning set should be equal to V. Okay. Don't worry, our aim is B is maximal linearly independent set. Okay. So let us pick if V is in, so pick a vector in V which is not in B, then what can you say about this V? V is an element of big V, and B spans V. So if B spans V, any vector in V must be expressed as a linear combination of the vectors in B. Tamam? Good. Then V is a linear combination, of elements of B. So the way that I'm going to prove B is maximal linearly independent set, I am going to show you that if you put an extra vector to the set B, then it becomes linearly dependent. So we pick a vector outside of V. Since B is a basis, it must be expressed as a linear combination of elements in B. Then if you consider this subset of V, V union V, what can you say about this set? This set must be, this set must be linearly dependent. Because V is a linear combination of the elements here. Tamam mı? Okay. Is linearly dependent. Is linearly dependent. Okay. So this finishes this part of the proof. So you have a linearly independent, since B is a basis, we already know that B is a linearly independent set by definition. Now, if you add an additional element to this set, it becomes linearly dependent. So this is a maximal linearly independent subset of V. Tamam? Anlaştık mı? Now we are going to prove 2 implies 3. And in the third condition tells us that B is a minimal spanning set of V. What does it mean? No proper subset of B spans V. Tamam. Teşekkür ederim. Now in the second condition, we start with a linearly independent set. B is linearly independent. And B is maximally linearly independent set. Maximum. Tamam. Linearly independent for any V in B Now consider this set. So V is in B. Take out V from your set. Tamam. So what you can say is V should not belong to this spanning set. Why? Because B is linearly independent. If you pick any element from B, it shouldn't be expressed as a linear combination of the other elements of B. Tamam mı? Good. So, if you consider a proper subset of B, for example, this is a proper subset of B, but you cannot span all of V, big V, with this set because it will not contain this element. So, no proper subset of B, no proper subset, no proper subset of B. Can span. Tamam mıyız? Anlaştık mı? Because if V is an element of this linear span of B minus V, it will imply that B is linearly dependent. Tamam mıyız? Anlaştık mı? Good. Now we are going to prove that if you have a subset of your vector space, which is minimal spanning set for your vector space, then it must be a basis. 3 implies 1. Any questions up to this point? Tamam. Ha, tahtanın önünde vakit geçsin diye şey yapıyorum. Yazıyorlarsa. Okay. Three plus one. Okay. Now, condition three tells you that the spanning set of B, ben burada bir sürü hareket yapıyorum. Oradan adam boş boş geçiyor. Oraya bakıyorsun. Hala. Bir şey yok orada. Atraksiyon burada. Evet. Now, the third condition already tells you that B is a spanning set for your vector space. For such a set to be a basis, you need to show that that set is linearly independent. Tamam? So this is what we are going to show. So suppose B is linearly dependent. Suppose B is linearly dependent. So what does this mean? So if B is linearly dependent, it means ne var oğlum dışarıda? Bir şey de yok.
Onlar da boş.
Evet. Evet, şimdi öğrencinin ilgisini çekmek için atraksiyon, gerginlik yaratacaksınız. Kimin üzerinde? Elif. Evet. Şimdi dışarıdakilere satışıyorum. A subset of a vector space is linearly dependent means, ne demek? A subset of a vector space is linearly dependent. That means, yani. That means there must be at least one element in this set which can be expressed as a linear combination of the remaining vectors in that set. Tamam. So, i.e. there exists a vector in U, there exists U in B such that if you consider the spanning set of linear span of this set, U must belong to this set. No? Ben diyeceğim ki orada bari bir şey, birileri geçiyor gidiyorsun. Yok, hiçbir şey yok. Vay anasını, ben burada 50 takla atıyorum, adam oradaki gölgeye bakıyor. Oradan anlatayım. Evet. Condition 3 tells us that B is a minimal spanning set for our vector space. If it is linearly dependent, then there is a vector in this set B which can be expressed as a linear combination of the remaining. So what can you say about this subspace? What can you say about this subspace? We already know that spanning set, linear span of B is, linear span of B is, what is linear span of B? V. V is a spanning set for our vector space. Tamam. Now what can you say about the linear span of this set? Adam oradan anlıyor. Değil mi? Aynen. Şimdi onlar oradan kalkıp gidiyor. Evet. Yer değiştirdiler. Evet, bu ne? What is the linear span of this set? Vallahi bak şu arkadaşınızın yüzüne kez de batacağım. Evet, if B, the linear span of B is V and U is already in this spanning set, then linear span of this set is already B. What does this contradict? Where is the contradiction? Where is the contradiction? Söyle. B cannot be minimal spanning set in this case. This contradicts the minimality of B, which contradicts the minimality of B. Tamam. Again, is if there exists only one U, then it is V. V. No, it was wrong. Okay. Tamam. Any questions? Tamam mıyız burada? Evet. Olamıyor. Evet, şimdi condition 3 çok güzel. Bir önceki notlara çalışılmış, gelmiş. Üçün ne olduğu belli. Üçün ne olduğunu kimse hatırlamadığı için. Condition 3. So we start with a vector space. V condition 3 tells us that we have a subset of V, namely the set B, which is a minimal spanning set for R vector space V. What is a minimal? What does a minimal subset, minimal spanning set mean? No proper subset of B can span V. Tamam. So we have a minimal spanning set for V. We want to prove that such a set must be a basis. What do we need to show? We need to show that a minimal spanning set for a vector space is linearly independent. Because by definition, a basis is a spanning set for our vector space, which is linearly independent. Tamam. So here we have a spanning set, which is minimal. Now we assume that such a set is linearly dependent. If you have a linearly dependent set, then there must be at least one element in your set which can be expressed as a linear combination of the remaining elements. Tamam. So actually, if you have a linearly dependent set, if you consider the spanning set of a linearly dependent set, there are some extra terms which have no effect on the spanning set. For example, in R2. Give me a linearly dependent set in R2. Give me a linearly dependent set in R2. Ben sonra kendimi bazen videolar gün sesimi açmıyorum. Acayip garip geliyor bana ama hareketlerime bakıyorum. Evet söyle. Linearly dependent. Tamam. Give me a linearly dependent set in R2. 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So if you consider this set, as a subset of R2. So if this is your set, this is a linearly dependent set. So if you want to consider the linear span of this set, since it is linearly dependent, there must be some extra terms which have no effect on the linear span. In this one, for example, you can immediately take this. Actually, you can choose any one of them, and then you can throw it away. For example, this can be expressed as a linear combination of these two. So if you throw this away, nothing changes in the linear span. Tamam? So if your set is linearly dependent, then you can, there must be an element which can be expressed as a linear combination of the others. So U can be expressed as a linear combination. So since U has no effect on the linear span, because it can be expressed in terms of the others, and if B spans V, this set should also span V, which contradicts the minimality, because this is a proper subset of B, still spanning R vector space. Tamam. Evet. Any questions, group online? Yok. Perfecto. Next we are going to, actually we are going to define the dimension of a vector space. Tamam. So actually we will mostly talk about finite dimensional spaces. I will just mention what we mean by an infinite dimensional space. So a dimension of a vector space will be the number of elements in any basis for that vector space. For this sentence to make sense, we should prove that any basis for a given vector space has the same number of elements. Because we already know that there might be more than one basis for a given, there are more than one basis for a given vector space. Tamam? Anlaştık. And that dimension will be a number, so we will mainly work with finite dimensional vector spaces. But let me at least mention what we mean by an infinite dimensional vector space. So for if your space is finite dimensional, no, then it will have a finite basis, a subset consisting of finitely many vectors. So if you have a vector space consisting of finitely many vectors in it, your vector space will be finite dimensional. So you will not be able to find infinitely many linearly independent vectors in that set. Actually, any number of vectors greater than the number, the cardinality of your basis will be linearly dependent. Tamam. So for us, a definition, a vectors, a vector space. A vector space. Şimdi içinden diyor sen daha az değilsin, sağa sola gitme. Evet, vector space is said to be finite dimensional if there exists a finite basis for V, and if not, we will call it an infinite dimensional vector space. So if you have a vector space in which you can find infinitely many linearly independent vectors, it will be called an infinite dimensional vector space. And this is how much we are going to be interested in such spaces. Mainly we will work with finite dimensional spaces. A vector space which is not finite dimensional is called infinite dimensional. Infinite dimensional vector space. Senin adın ne?
Hasan.
İlk defa geldin sınıfa.
İlk defa gelmiştim.
Evet desen ne olurdu? Evet hocam, aa nasıl hemen fark ettiniz desen, havam olsaydı şurada. Sosyal mesafe dediğin yer. Siz nerede oturuyorsunuz? Sandalyede mi oturuyorsunuz? Biraz aynı. Neyse artık, ne yapayım? Oturun. Evet. Tamam. Tamam mıyız? Peki. Tamam. Next, we are going to prove this statement. Okay. Theorem. Bir kere daha söyleyeyim. In below the video on about the lecture on Tuesday on YouTube, there were questions of Emir, who is not in class today. Emir Gül, okay. Emir, tamam. So you can check my answers and then you can ask your answers. Ask your questions. Niye answer'ını ask ediyorsun? Tamam. Anlaştık. Baktın mı Elif videoları? Yok. Ben güzel çıkmıştım. Ben çıkıyorum. Evet, biraz da sizi göstersek aslında. Televizyona çıktım diye. Aslında öyle yapalım. Mesela sen evdekilere gösterirsin. Gelir videoya. Anne baba. Sen de gelmek mi istiyorsun ekrana? Ne?
Give me a vector which has a finite base.
Give me a vector. Give me a vector. Tamam dur, şimdi tekrar edelim. Give me a vector. Give me a, bir dakika, şimdi hayır, online grup da duysun diye yapıyorum. Give me a vector space. Tamam. Ben de online grup sizi duymuyor diye, hani onlar da eksik kalmasın. Give me a vector space.
Which has finite bases.
Which has finite bases. R2. 1, 0, 0, 1. Two elements. Tamam. Anlaştık. Tamam. Ben de bir an infinite bases soracaksın sandım da bir korktum. Sırtımdan ter boşalıyordu. Geçti artık, sorsaydım. Bir daha söyleyeyim. For R2, 1, 0, 0, 1 is a basis. 2, 0, 0, 2 is another basis. So there are infinitely many bases that you can write for a given vector space. So a basis for a vector space is not unique. What does not change is the number of elements in a given, what does not change is the number of elements in a given basis. For R2, a basis will always contain two elements. But there are infinitely many ways to write a basis for R2, for example. Tamam?
Okay.
Allah'ım, bunca şey söyledikten sonra ha tamam, basis uniktir mi çıktı? Sen merak etme, online grupta kimse bilmiyor. Kerem, ne demek basis uniktir? Yürü. Hadi buradan yürü. Number, the cardinality of basis. If you have a vector space, for this sentence, for this notion, cardinality of a basis, I am going to restrict myself to finite dimensional vector spaces. If you have a vector space, finite dimensional, what is an invariant for that vector space is the number of elements, the cardinality of any basis. That is unique. Sen şu an yapacağın profesyoneller ha deyip bu iş burada. Tamam. Okay. Now, theorem. If a vector space has a finite spinning set, then it has a finite basis. Okay. So here, what I am going to prove is, if you have a spinning set for your vector space, how you can turn that spinning set into a basis. Tamam? Because for us, a finite dimensional, then it, yes. So this will be a finite dimensional vector space. If you have a spinning set, tamam? So if it is linearly independent, then it is already a basis. If not, there must be an element in that set which can be expressed as a linear combination of the remaining terms. Throw it away. Work with the remaining terms. Linear span will not change if you throw away a linearly dependent element. Tamam? And then look at the remaining elements. If they are linearly independent, then you have a basis. Tamam? So this is the idea. The way that I'm going to write the proof is, take a linear span. It has a finite spinning set. I'm going to take a finite set. Okay, let me write the proof. Proof. Let V is equal to linear span. So this set is a spinning set for your vector space. For some finite subset S of V. If S is linearly independent, then S is a basis. If this set is not linearly independent, otherwise, So otherwise there exists an elementless quality as U1 in this set such that U1 is in this spinning set S throw away U1. Tamam. Now we know that then şöyle diyelim. This linear span, if you consider the linear span of this set, then this is equal to V. If, so let's call this set, if S1, let's call this set as S1, which is S, throw away this linearly dependent vector. U1 is linearly independent. Independent then S1 is a basis. If not, you will repeat this process. Otherwise, one can repeat this process. Which has to stop since S is a finite set. Eventually, we end up with a subset S sub K of S such that SK is linearly independent. And okay, so kime baktığım hakkında hiç kimse fikir yok değil mi? Sayın Sumuti. Sumuti sütlü bir çay mı? Yani sütle de yapıyoruz. Kendi ürünümüz. Sen spor mu yapıyorsun? Kantinde oturuyordun. Kantinde oturuyorum. Oradan buraya geliyorum çok. Şimdi sen de şey diye düşün, benden mi bahsediyor? Evet. Sen ne spor yapıyorsun? Hadi ya. Boks topu değil mi? Tamam. Tamam. Kavuz açılsa bir daha beni zor görürsünüz. Benim kloro alerjim var. Hiçbir şeyle bir kere hapşırırım burada. Evet. Tamam. Hadi bakalım. Tamam. Şöyle yazsın. Evet. Tamam. What
I want to tell you here is if you have a linear, if you have a spanning set for your vector space, you may reduce it to a basis for your vector space. Suppose you have 5 vectors in your spanning set. So you have a vector space and you know that 5, these given 5 elements span your vector space. The algorithmic way to reduce this to a basis is start from the 5th vector, the last vector, and try to understand whether it can be expressed as a linear combination of the previous 4. If not, keep it here. If it is a linear combination of its predecessors, throw it away from your spanning set. If it is not, if it cannot be expressed as a linear combination of the first 4, keep it in your basis. Then proceed to the 4th vector. Do the same. Can you express this as a linear combination of its predecessors? If it can be expressed, throw it away. Tamam. This is the algorithmic way to reduce any given spanning set to a basis. Tamam. Anlaştık. So if you have a finite spanning set for your vector space, by throwing away linearly dependent elements, you can end up with a basis. Here, if you do this in, if you do k steps, eventually this process will finish and then you will end up with a basis. Tamam? Söyle. Independent ya, evet. Öyle şeyler yapıyorum ya, çok hayli azıcık. Okay, so if you have an element like this, so you have, you start with 5 vectors spanning your vector space. Say one of the vectors in your spanning set can be already expressed as a linear combination of the others. Tamam. Now, if you have such an element in your spanning set, this spanning set must be linearly dependent. Now, throw that away. If you throw away a linearly dependent set from a spanning set, nothing will change in terms of the linear span. Tamam. Evet. Tamam. We will meet in 17 minutes. Of course. Ay dur. Bir dakika, videoyu kapattım. Geri başlattım. Ama gittim bir kere. Okay. Haydi. So let us solve an example. Let me give you a vector space and I want you to construct a basis for that vector space. Okay. Example. Compute a basis of, okay, here is your vector space V, X, Y, Z in R3 such that 2X minus Y is equal to 0. Okay, first let us do this. Şöyle yapayım. First let us solve this part and then I'm going to make that tree. So if, so first of all, if you consider those points x, y in R2 such that 2x minus y is equal to zero, this is a subspace of R2. Tamam. And if you have a subspace of a given vector space, it is also a vector space by itself. Tamam. Now, give me a basis for this vector space. So if in this case, because if you look, so this is the line with equation y is equal to 2x, a line passing through the origin, it is a subspace of R2, and a basis for this vector space will be 1, comma 2. Give me another basis for this vector space. 2, 4. Tamam. Actually, if you have a one-dimensional vector space, okay. So the number of, this is what I'm going to tell you in a minute. The number of elements in a given basis for a vector space is called the dimension of that vector space. Tamam. So this is a one-dimensional vector space. If you have a one-dimensional vector space, and if you want to find the basis for that vector space, it is enough to pick a non-zero vector from that vector space. Tamam? Anlaştık mı? Now the original question. What does this equation represent? It represents a plane. Tamam. Passing through the origin. So it is a subspace of R2. Tamam. How many elements you need to span such a vector space? At least two. Tamam. At least two. So you need to now give me a spinning set for this vector space. So you are going to write two elements from this vector space, and you want them to be linearly independent. If you have two vectors in a set, they are going to be linearly independent if none of them is a multiple of the other. So first of all, if you take 1, 2, 0, this is a vector in this vector space, and take 0, 0, 1. Now these two vectors form a linearly independent set, and then you can check that these two vectors span any vector in this vector space. Tamam? Anlaştık. So and now you can add any number of elements to this set. It will still be a spanning set, but it will no longer be linearly independent. Tamam? It is minimal in terms of spanning sets for this vector space. If you take any proper subset of this set, it will not span this vector space. It is maximal in terms of linear independence. If you add more vectors, if you add one more vector to this set, it will become linearly dependent. Tamam. Okay. Next, we are going to prove that any basis for a given vector space will have the same number of elements. Let V be a vector space. Let V be a vector space. With a basis, the basis consisting of consisting of n elements then each basis then each basis of V has n elements. So although a basis for a given vector space is not unique, the number of elements in that set in a basis is always the same. Tamam. Let us see a proof of this statement. Proof. One. Evet, Ayşe Nazlı. Tamam. Eğer Zafer turunda değilsen, correct. Proof. So let us start with a basis consisting of n elements. Let A be a basis of V having n elements. Arada bana sen mi sordun? Yok. O dersi gelmiyor herhalde. Having n elements. Okay. And let us pick another basis. Let B be any other basis, any other basis having m elements. Now, so we have two bases with n elements and m elements respectively. Now, since A is a spinning set, and B is linearly independent, now if you have a spinning set for your vector space consisting of n elements and if you have a basis consisting of m elements, which one is greater, m or n? So here I only use spinning property of A. A is for us a spinning set for our vector space. And now I take B as a basis, where B as a linear, and B is linearly independent. So which one is, which number is greater? N is, N should be greater than or equal to. Yeah. So I only tell you that A is a spinning set. So the number of elements can probably be larger than linear independent. And now we will switch roles. Similarly, since A is linearly independent, and B is a spinning set, We have n less than or equal to n. Okay.
Tamam mıyız? İşte Nazlıeronat. Ne? Bir yer deneyeyim onu. Ha. Cevap veriyor. Çok güzel. Okay. Now let us see some consequences of this theorem. Consequences. If V has a basis of n elements, then any set of n plus one, then any set of n plus one or more vectors is linearly dependent. If a vector space, if a vector space contains an infinite linearly independent subset, then it is an infinite dimensional vector space. Okay. And finally, if a vector space has a basis of n vectors, then all bases plural, singular'ı aynı. Basis for V have n vectors. Now, with the last remark, we are ready to define the dimension of a vector space. One, two. All right, no. Definition. Okay, now we will stick to the finite dimensional vector spaces. Suppose V is a finite dimensional finite dimensional
vector space, vector space, then the cardinality, of a basis is said to be the dimension of V and we are going to denote this by denoted by okay. Now observations. Any questions? Acayip kesiyor burası. Yok ya, psikolojik onlar. Ayaklarımın içi donuyor benim burada. Observation. Let us start with a vector space of dimension n. Let V be a vector space. Of dimension and A be a subset of V containing M vectors. One. If A is linearly independent, then what can you say about M and N? Söyle. Sanki şey diyor değil mi? N is less than or equal to N. Aynı şeyi iki kere söylüyor. Böyle mi dedin?
Ha.
Böyle dedim.
Evet.
Yes.
Sanki tezahür değil mi? Hocam bunu da
dinleyelim. Evet. Ne diyor? Sinir etme beni diyor. If M is greater than N, then what can we conclude? A is linearly dependent. Then A is linearly dependent. If A is linearly independent and M is equal to M, then A is a basis for P. So if your vector space is n dimensional and if you have a set of n linearly independent vectors, it must be a basis. Bunu böyle tutuyorum. Çok hızlı çekince sorun oluyor. Bilmezsiniz, YouTuber'lık çok zor. Ben geçen dönem böyle panikle tahtanın önünde gidiyorum, geliyorum. Çok hareket, yavaş yavaş. Sonra bunları çok çabuk kaldırıyorum, bekliyorum. Onun için böyle duruyorum burada. Valla geçen dönem ben ilk bir video çektim böyle, orada yediğim dinçi hiç unutamam. Dinçi sıkabilir yani. Evet, onun için şimdi çok dikkat ediyorum. Hadi bunu ben yapayım. Logaritmada da var ya, üst dışı öne. Bu öne düştü. Ya. Dur. Söyle bar.
A. En
basit. N plus one. Remember, we have so. We talk about a stem. Although there are many bases for a given vector space, for Rn, we have a standard basis. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. For this, we have a standard basis. 1, x, x squared, x to the n. Çok önemli. Tamam. Evet. Tamam, sonra yarışırız sözde. Vay vay. Ben bir kere Kıbrıs'ta ders verdim. O zaman da böyle havuza gidiyordum akşamları. Bir tane öğrenci var yüzme takımında. Adam bütün yaz beni şey yaptı. Böyle havuzda hadi yarışalım. Siz gidin, ben ondan sonra başlayacağım, yarışalım. Ama en son şöyle yaptım. Derste soru söyledim, hadi kim önce çözecek. Derste öyle, akşamları havuzda öbür türlü bir şey. Evet. Now. Actually, so if I give you Rn as a vector space, we always think it as a vector space over the real numbers. And for us, this is a vector space over the real numbers. A vector space always comes with a field. So for these vector spaces, if I don't tell you anything, we are going to treat them as vector spaces over the field of real numbers. But now let's talk about complex numbers. Now, every field is a vector space over itself. R, the real numbers, is a vector space over R. R is a vector space over R of dimension one. Tamam mı? Bunda en fikir miyiz? R is a vector space over R of dimension one. Helen, give me a basis for R. Give me a basis for R. Bir tane sayı söyle. Perfect. One is a basis for R. Any non-zero number is a basis for the vector space R. Tamam? Because you can obtain any Ayşe Nazlı Eronat da valla burada döktürüyor. Evet.
Hocam ben bir
consider tamam oraya şey yapmadım. Yani. Now, complex numbers. Now let us focus on this field business. Now, if you consider complex numbers as a vector space over the real numbers. So, let me mention it here. Dimension of our vector space. Now, whenever necessary, I am going to put the field here. Dimension of C as a vector space over the field of real numbers. So what is the effect of this field? So when we say scalar multiplication, those scalars, those numbers will be only real numbers. So you can, whenever you take a vector, remember how we construct, how we write a linear combination. A linear combination of a set of vectors means if you have v1, v2, v3, c1 times v1 plus c2 times v2 plus c3 times v3. Those c1, c2, c3 must come from your field. Now, complex numbers will form a vector space with the usual addition of complex numbers and multiplication with a real number. Tamam. Now, what is the dimension of this vector space? 2. And give me a basis when you treat complex numbers as a vector field over the real numbers. 1 and r. So, 1, r, a basis. So, if this is a basis, we should be able to obtain any complex number as a linear combination of these two vectors. Now, if you think this as a vector space over the real numbers, when you form a linear combination, constants will come from real numbers. Now, if you consider what is the dimension here?
One.
Give me a basis.
One
or I? It doesn't matter because remember, if you have a vector space of one dimension, any non-zero vector will give you a basis. Tamam? Sen hocanın esprilerine falan diyorsun değil mi? Seneye böyle yüz gene aynı ders dışı yaparız. Evet. Tamam. If you have a vector space of one dimension, if you want to find a basis, all you need to do is pick a non-zero vector for your vector space. Both one and r, these are basis. Actually, any non-zero complex. What is the difference? Now, if this is a basis for your vector space, then you should be able to obtain any complex number as a multiple of one. When I say a multiple, I mean multiply with a scalar. Scalars will come from the complex numbers. Tamam? Good. Okay. Any questions? 2, 1, Ayşe Nazlı Eronat. Tamam. Teorem. Of course, G of a vector space and consider it one of its subspaces, the dimension of a subspace will be less than or equal to the dimension of the whole vector space. So when I say a proper subspace, so if you take a vector space V, of course V can be taken as a subspace of itself. When I say proper subspace, I mean subspaces which are not V. Tamam. If V is a finite dimensional vector space, if V is a finite dimensional vector space, and W is a proper subspace of V, then dimension of W is less than dimension of V. Tamam. Proof. Okay, so first of all, V is a finite dimensional vector space. So V has a basis containing finitely many vectors, and it is the maximal linearly independent subset. So if V is finite dimensional, W must also be finite dimensional. Tamam. Okay. Since V is finite dimensional, so is W. Now let us pick a basis for W, so it must be a finite basis. Let this W1, Wm be a basis for W. So actually, in the proof, what I want you to observe is if you have a vector space, and in that vector space, if you have a linearly independent set, you can extend that linearly independent set to a basis for your vector space. Tamam. Now this M elements, the set of M elements is linearly independent, because it is a basis for W. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to extend this to a basis for the bigger space. Oh. Okay. So since this is a proper subspace, there must be some vectors which is not in W. So pick one of them. Now, what can you say about this set? What can you say about this set? What can you say about this set? It is linearly independent. All you need to check is, can you write V as a linear combination of V1, Vn? No, because this is an element outside of W. The spanning set of these M elements is W already. Tamam? So this set must be linearly independent. Is linearly independent in V. Okay. Çok çok güzel. Bir Elif, iki Elif, üç Elif. Mısır goy goy olsun diye. Okay. Now, what we observed here is V. So W has a basis consisting of M vectors. So what do we know? The dimension of W is M. Tamam? Because it has a basis consisting of M vectors. So we cannot get any linearly independent set of more than M elements in W. Tamam. But now if you look at V, in V we have a set consisting of N plus 1 vectors. What does this tell you about the dimension of V? Dimension of V is at least N plus 1. Because you have at least n plus 1 linearly independent set of vectors. Tamam? Okay. So this implies V contains n plus 1 vectors. Which are linearly independent. Okay, now what do we want to show? We want to show that dimension of W is less than dimension of V. Suppose this is not true. So if dimension of V, so dimension of W is M, because we have a basis for W consisting of M vectors. If dimension of V is less than M, then we shouldn't be able to find a linearly independent set which has more than M vectors, right? Şunu yazayım bir daha. If a basis of V contains n or less number of vectors, which means if the dimension of V is less than the dimension of W. Tamam. Then, şöyle. Then, there cannot be a set with cardinality. Plus one, which is nearly independent. So this implies dimension of V is less than or equal to 1+. So if W is a proper subspace of V, and if the dimension of W is M, then the proof tells us that then there must be a basis of W consisting of M vectors. Since W is a proper subspace of V, there must be some vectors which are not in W. Pick one of them and add it to that linearly independent set. It must also be linearly independent because V1 up to Vm only span W. So they cannot span a vector V, which is not in W. So W1 up to Wm plus the vector V is linearly independent. So now if you think that dimension of V is less than or equal to W, If the dimension of V is less than or equal to M, we shouldn't be able to find M plus one linearly independent set of vectors. Tamam. Do we have any questions? Hayrola Elif'im? Tamam. Tamam. Söyle.
Hocam, you are all three companies and the problem is first.
Evet. Thank you. If there is no more questions, that is independent. Thank you. Güzel, doğru. Evet, that is all for this week.